Everybody participated in practice today, with the exception of, well, Powell participated in the non-contact parts of it, and he's continuing to make progress. And so, but everybody else is doing better.
How do you game plan for a team like the Wizards who have played no NBA games, have a bunch of new pieces? How do you kind of build a plan to go against them on Wednesday?
Well, you study their preseason games. You study our games from last year, and they still got a few guys playing on their team from last year. I mean, Beal's obviously still on the team. He's a great player, and he's playing the game more like a point guard than he ever has. So. Everybody knows what he can do from the outside, but he's driving it. He's passing it. Every year he becomes more of a complete player, and I mean, he's one of those talents in the league that is, he's an MVP caliber talent. There's just no question about it.
What's different about Washington if they don't have John Wall?
Well, Beal ends up having the ball more, which is not a bargain, And again, he's in a lot of instances he's the de facto point guard and playmaker. So having a guy with the ball that much, it's such a threat to do so many different things: shoot it, drive it, draw fouls, make plays, all those things. Big challenge.
Did you see enough out of Porzingis in the preseason to know that he's over the injury? You're not worried about the injury anymore.
He's done extremely well. Look, his process is it's day to day. Just every day, keep working towards better rhythm, better better feel, teammates, all those kinds of things. But he's put in an incredible amount of work. And really worked himself back to a position that he's in now.
Rick, what's the,
is that it?
Do you feel more encouraged about what you've seen from your team defensively the last couple of games, or is it still a lot more work to do?
Well, the last two games have definitely been more encouraging. I mean, the first three we were giving up 121 a game, which is not good. The last couple have been significantly better, but we've got to build on those last two games and take it to the regular season. And Washington's a big test. They're very scary team because of their shooting ability. They picked up Bertans. He's a great shooter. They got a lot of guys that Wagner is a big guy that can shoot it. Bryant is shooting, I think, 40% for preseason. And so, it's they're a team that plays with a lot of energy.
What's the key for your bigs in guarding a pick and roll against a team like that?
Guarding pick and roll?
Yeah, for your bigs against a team like that.
Well, it's really challenging because of the way they stretch you out. And their bigs pick and pop. And then you got guys like Beal going downhill. It's tough not to get into full rotation, and when you get into full rotation, that really puts your defense in scramble. And so we just got to be real solid. Our basic coverages have to be on point. We got to be really tied together. Otherwise, these guys can put up a lot of points.
How much did Seth Curry improve the 1 year he was away from the team with Portland?
Well, his biggest improvement was his health situation. He got stronger, got his legs back under him after the 1 year where he missed. And so he's had a really, really good training camp. He's feeling good today after missing one of those games. And I think he's one of the best shooters in the game. And no team in this league right now can have too much shooting.
Is this the deepest Western Conference?
I guess it's the last several years. It's just been really tough, and it appears to be greater parity across the board as well. And so everybody's margins for error are going to be very slim. And that's, you can look at it a couple ways. You can, look at it and lament how hard it is, or you can look at it and say, hey, this is one hell of a challenge, and I think that's obviously the way we got to attack it.